supposed to. Huh. Might run that check while I'm sending a Uber. If you don't know me, I'm good with computers. If it ain't about money, I ain't tryna chill. 20 profits, I'm flooded with bills. Most of my bitches, they spoil like some milk. Mention on the way that bitch getting built. Rental car service, I check me an M. My life a movie and my life a film. I'm getting money on the front and the back end. He ain't the plug if he said it, he taxing. Favor for favor, I do
what. Alright, in today's video, we're gonna talk about what you listen to is what you will become. Now, a lot of people, you know, listen to their parents, they listen to their grandparents, they listen to their friends, they listen to a whole lot of people who will tell them to do things that they've never done. As far as one of the most common things that people tell, you know, their kids is go to college. 40% of the parents that's telling you to go to college never been to college. Your parents is basically listening to the TV, you know, or listening to people who they heard say go to college, right? Now, when you go to school, right, you listening to your teacher tell you to get a job and go to college so you can get a job. They're brainwashing you early, even in elementary school. It starts in elementary school. They're brainwashing you early, telling you to go to college, you know, go to school to get a job. They're not saying, well, you know, grow up and get a business and become a millionaire, become a billionaire, get a good credit score. They're not telling you the right things. Your parents is not telling you the right things. They just want you to work a job and be normal like them. Another thing that I hate the most, you might not feel it or you not, might not see it, or you may see it or you may feel it, right? But a lot of parents, right, they go through what is called a little jealousy. You know what I'm saying? Some parents see their kids getting real successful and kind of get jealous because they was never successful. Some people, even your parents, even your friends, even your brothers and sisters, do not want you to do better than them. They do not want you to do better than them in life, right? So you might even have your parents don't want you to do better than them, you know? Because they're older, they feel like, damn, you know, you got a better car, you living better, you got more money, your banking account's bigger. So by you doing good, they might feel like a failure. Even though there are some good parents that see their kids doing good and actually be proud, but there are some parents who see their kids do good and kind of get jealous, right? So I listen to who's rich, who been through things, you know what I mean? And actually learn from their mistakes and actually still have money to this day. I listen to successful people because I can't listen to a person who been working at a job for 30 years, you know what I'm saying? And didn't get the picture of getting a business and actually getting rich. Nothing is wrong with that, but that's not my way of trying to get rich or trying to get successful. Not saying that the person that's working a job, you know, is not successful. They successful in their own way. They where they want to be. But my plans and my picture to life is way bigger than just that. So me telling you, you know, you are what you listen to is very true, because you can go listen to somebody, you know, say go join a gang, right? Now you want to be a gang member and all the rules that they're telling you about being a gang member, right? It can actually be harming for your mindset. It can actually be dangerous. It can actually ruin your whole life, right? So I just look at it like, by me being a person of God, you know, that's always praying and stuff, I feel like your dreams and what you should do is your own way. Can't nobody really determine how your life should be. Only you know, and only God is going to know how your life is going to be, because any other angle that you take that don't belong to you, you will fail at it. So that's another thing that I preach all the time. If you are doing something, right, and it's not making you rich, please stop doing it and figure out ways to make you rich, right? Give it like a 1 year, 2 year span. If it hasn't made you millions of dollars, change it up, because that's not it. You should go out, meet the right connections, meet the right people. You know, like I said, hire a mentor. You know, I got plenty of things that's coming on my Kevin Connects that I'm gonna be talking about, you know, different types of connections, different types of lenders, different types of people who you can actually meet that will actually help you out. I will post different types of investors, just different types of things that I always wanted to know that I never knew that I'm gonna let y'all know. You know what I mean? Another thing that's wrong with this world, people don't really like to give the secrets to life. They like to hide them in. They like to keep you, you know, under a rock. They want to be the only one shining. Stay away from them people that just want to be the only one shining. They don't want me telling you game on YouTube because they want to be the only ones making money. They want to be the only ones with the knowledge. They want to be the only ones knowing this or knowing that. They don't, nah, man, Kevo, he going around telling people, man, about their credit, man. Hell no, let their credit be bad. Those type of people want you to fail. You gotta hang around straight winners. You gotta hang around people who motivate. Watch people who motivate. Also, while you're watching, make sure that you are working on your life at the same time. Always stay working on your life at the same time, because you can watch somebody and get motivated, get happy. Don't become a hater. That's not gonna do nothing but hinder your life and stop your life. You hating on me doesn't do anything for me or for you. That's only makes your life worse, because I'm doing great, right? So, I mean, at the end of the day, get some mentorship from somebody. And after you get some mentorship from somebody, take the advice, add it to your life, add some value to your life, right? And then see how you can capitalize off of the information that they have gave you to go to the next level. That's all you really can do. Because at the end of the day, time is wasting. You get older. And, you know, it's a lot of opportunity out here. You definitely don't want to miss it. Every time you see me, I'm always trying to make something happen. I'll be in my phone, right? Every time I pick up my phone, I am trying to make something happen. What are you doing to your phone daily? You know what I'm saying? What are you doing on the internet daily? Are you trying to motivate people? Are you on their hating? Are you on their hating comment? Are you, like, what are you doing daily? So, also, I want to talk about the key to wealth, right? The key to wealth is minimizing what you spend. Minimize your expenses and increase the income that you are making, right? So let's say if you are making $50,000, right? If you're just throwing away half of your money on nothing that's not helping your business grow, then you're wasting your time. If I make $50,000, right? And I invest $40,000 to make that $50,000 triple, then I'm doing good. That's the only way that I will throw away money. That's called throwing away, but it's reinvesting. Now, your throwaway money could be just going to the clubs, buying clothes, doing this, this, and this, and it's not going towards anything. It's not going towards no value. So what you want to do is you want to always figure out ways to triple the money that you are making. Always. It's not about just getting money and spending the money to make yourself look cool, because money potentially ends up running out, right? So figure out a way to triple any type of income that you are making. Get the money and figure out ways to, okay, if you are building a brand, figure out ways to how to become the best marketer. If you are an entrepreneur, figure out ways to continue to grow your business. Get a magazine placement, you know, meet the right people to take you to the next level, man, you know? So also, I have made a post, right? And it said, let me tell y'all what it said. It said, these big rappers need to start putting these girls they're dating in contracts, because they're getting free promo in their relationships, income, you know what I'm saying, all types of stuff. Then the girl ended up breaking up with a guy, and he wasted time, his money, he blew her up, and he didn't get nothing. So I want to talk a little bit about that as well, because I just want to say this, man. Like, if you are a big rapper, right, and you are meeting these girls, and they are under you, right, and you are blowing them up, it's almost like blowing an artist up, right? Because she's your girl, but you're blowing her up, you're buying her jewelry, you buying her the cars, you're doing this, this, and this. And when they look at you, right? When social media looks at you, they're looking at you as a whole now, right? So you just put this whole female a part of your brand, and shorty breaks up with you, right? Because you done boss her up. Don't get me wrong, you and her together, but now y'all on the same level. Now, the type of men that have more money than you will be trying to go after this type of woman, because if they see this lady at the light in a nice 2021 Bentley or 2021 Rolls Royce truck, right? They're gonna think she's doing 10 times better. This is how guys think. In their mind, they think that when they see women, they think that she's so successful, she's beautiful. Now let's say if she sees one of these guys that's worth 200 million at the light, now he wants her so bad, right? It's really your fault you took it to that next level, right? Now, you don't got this lady under contract. You don't got this lady under nothing. Now, if she decides to move on, she broke your brand, right? Your brand that she had with you kind of tarnished, depending on what she say, right? Also, she takes the rings, the purses, the chains, the banking account, the promo. She can forever marking the next guy, right? And you don't get left with nothing because you overly capped with her. Now you gotta delete her pictures off of Instagram, and you gotta do this and do that. When it's like, man, just put these girls on the contract, man. Like, if you're a big rapper or a big ball player or whatever you is, that you got a lot of bag, man, you got to secure the bag. All these rappers rap all about all this cock. Your own enemy can be right up under you as a female, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? I ain't knocking the females, but I'm just basically saying is what I'm seeing happening a whole lot is these guys taking these girls to the next level and just getting on later for more fame or more money. It's steady happening, man. And my thing is, though, man, y'all continue to focus on the bag, man. Stay winning, man, like y'all is. Because like I said, y'all the brand, man. Whatever y'all step y'all name behind, that go. So I say keep building y'all artists up, man. You know, the same energy y'all putting in them females, man, put them in y'all artists and make millions of dollars. You know what I'm saying? Get the labels going. You know what I'm saying? And blow them to the next level. Because y'all doing it with these females and they end up leaving. Then now the whole internet laughing at you in a shade room and Ball Alert and all these rest of these pages talking about it. And all the girls taking the girl side and the guys taking the guy side, man, and all that. Now, it wouldn't even matter because guess what? Shorty, you can do whatever you want. I got you on a contract. I'm getting half of this, half of that, half of this, half of that. Because most of these rappers, y'all putting up a good half a ticket, a M, and ain't getting no profit. None. Just a little clout that, you know what I'm saying? But y'all already had y'all self. I mean, it's a great look, but I don't know. I'm just saying, though, you know, that's why I made the post. Because I feel like, you know, so many successful rappers do this. Successful ball players, successful everything, man. That's the number one thing that guys go through is dealing with love, man. And, you know, they be blind to it. You feel me? So I'm here, you know, push you on with it, let you know about how it's supposed to go, really. Also, man, make sure y'all follow my new artist, Will Got the Juice, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm still looking for more artists. Make sure y'all support my artist Juice. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram at bamat_kebo. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all subscribe to kevofans.com. Kevo Connects for any courses and guides. I still got my OnlyFans. So if y'all want to go in there and catch up on some information if you ever missed it, I still got the OnlyFans.